In today's video, I'm going to show you how to download a cool 3D retro TV and use it in Adobe After Effects. First, we need to get our 3D retro TV. Here's how you do it. Go to a website called Sketchfab. It's a place where you can find all kinds of 3D models. Search for a 3D retro TV in the search bar. Once you find a model you like, click on it. Look for the download button and make sure to choose the GLB version. This is important because it's the file type that works with After Effects. Download the file to your computer. Now that you have your 3D TV, open up Adobe After Effects and bring your file into it. In your new file, make sure in your new comp settings you change the 3D render settings to advanced, or your GLB file will not work. Now just follow along what I do, and I will speak on the important things you will need to know when they come up. Since we are going to render this animation without a background, I will turn the shadow settings off and I'll just add a drop shadow later on to this. Make sure to change these settings before you render out this TV. Click on Advanced and select Render Options. Make sure your resolution is on double when you render, and turn up your smoothness and render quality up also. I'm doing this because you can't add CC to your GLB file. After your 3D TV is rendered, make a new comp with the footage you want to put in the TV. Add the scanlines effect to simulate old retro TV screens. This next effect we add, we will probably have to change the value of it later to adjust for our bend in the TV. It is called optics compensation. Let's bring your TV in now and let's put the footage onto it.